What's good, y'all? It's the one and only NY Fina, the most phenomenal voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, go on, subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew. Now, let's get to it. Listen, I want to apologize for not doing my Cowboys and Cardinals reaction the other day. I was going to do that, but I was busy yesterday. I was at work, and I really didn't have any time to record. So instead of me just doing a single Cardinals and Cowboys reaction right now, I'm just going to do a full week 7 recap. I'm not going to talk about every single game, but you know, who gives a fuck? I'm pretty sure y'all don't care about the Dolphins and the Jets. I'm pretty sure y'all don't want me to cover Dolphins and Jets or Lions and Jaguars. Let's cut it out. But as far as the big games that happen, we're going to speak about it real quick. Hear me out. I know y'all been waiting for me to say, me talk about this, but the Cowboys are some shit, B. The Cowboys are garbage. I don't know why I picked that team to win. I don't know why I thought Andy Dalton could come in and be successful. I don't know why. I really don't know why. This Cowboys team is pathetic. And you know the sad part? Because I see a lot of people bashing the Cowboys. And rightfully so. But you know what's the sad part about all of this? The fact that they're going to still win the division. Guess what? The Cowboys are still in first place, y'all. As pathetic as they look, Monday night versus the overrated Kyler Murray and the Cardinals. Because I'm still not huge on the Cardinals. Like, let's cut it out. As bad as it looked versus the Cardinals, they're still going to win the division. This team is... They already got chemistry issues, locker room issues. Players are already calling out Mike McCarthy and the defensive coordinator. I mean, it's full on pathetic. And it has me wondering, I gotta know something. Why did the Cowboys get rid of Chris Richard over some guy named Mike Nolan? You had one of the best young stud coordinators. Defensive coordinators in the NFL and Chris Richard, and you get rid of him for this? Unbelievable. You get rid of a defensive back guru. A guy that's worked with the LOB himself. Turned him to what, you know, one of the most dominant secondaries in all of NFL history. And you get rid of him for this? Unbelievable, dog. The Cowboys are exact. They're the exact representation of their owner themselves, Jerry Jones. The Cowboys are exact representation of Jerry Jones himself, y'all. This Cowboys team, I'm sorry. It looks like Dak is going to get paid, B. It looks like Dak is going to get paid because Andy Dalton isn't it. Andy Dalton looked bad, y'all. He just did. There's no excuse you can make for Andy Dalton. I don't care if you're the biggest Cowboys fan in the world. Andy Dalton looked awful. I get it. It was his first full game as it started. But my goodness. Zeke fumbling the ball every 2 seconds. Amari Cooper was put on lockdown for most of the game. This defense is awful. They can't stop the run. They can't stop the pass. They can't do nothing. This guy, the Cardinals had their way on offense. And guess what? It wasn't like Kyler Murray had a good game, y'all. Kyler Murray threw 9 for 24. 9 for 24, that's not even 50%. This guy, Kyler Murray, didn't even throw for 50%. And they blew him out by 28. You can't make this shit up, y'all. It's a disgrace. It's a disgrace that the Cowboys are going to win the NFC East by only winning 6 games, y'all. The winner of the NFC East division is only going to win like 6 games, y'all. This is how pathetic the NFC East is. Like, I might just have to throw the entire NFC East in the fire range. Like, real talk. It's getting that pathetic. Like, I'm at the point where if I'm Roger Goodell, y'all, I just cut out the NFC East come playoff time. Because none of these teams deserve to make the playoffs. I'm sorry. None of these teams deserve to make the playoffs. Like, I'm for real. Let's cut it out. But overall, looking at it from the Cardinals side, I'm still not impressed, y'all. Y'all play the Cowboys, whoop-de-doo. Andy Dalton is garbage, so you guys get no points for that. I still don't trust this team. The defense ain't as good as looked Monday night. You guys are still missing Chandler Jones. Chandler Jones is not coming back this year. So you guys lost your number one pass rusher. I don't think Kirkpatrick and Byron Murphy is going to look all this good all year long. I will see how good y'all look Sunday. I will see how good y'all look Sunday, 3 o'clock Eastern time. I will see how good you look come when you play in the grip money of Russell Wilson and DK Metcalf and Tyler Lockett and the whole entire crew. Alright, so fuck out of here, Cardinals fans. I'm not impressed. The other game of the night, it was early. It wasn't in the night. But Chiefs versus Bills. All I can really take from this game is the Bills aren't there yet. I mean, that's all I'm really taking away from this game is that the Bills aren't there yet. They're not Super Bowl contenders. Losing games to the Titans, getting blown out by the Titans, getting obliterated by Keen Henry and Ryan Tannehill themselves. And then getting outplayed by the Chiefs, who really didn't play exceptionally that game. I thought Mahomes played well. I'm going to keep it a buck. I'm putting all my Chiefs hate bias aside. I like how Patrick Mahomes is controlling the clock. I will give Chiefs fans that. That's one thing Patrick Mahomes has gotten better at. That's one thing I will say is Patrick Mahomes has got a lot better in controlling the clock. He's getting his Tom Brady on. What I mean by that is he's not trying to go out and score in three plays every single drive. He's making sure, I guess it's more with the running game. I mean, hell, when you're able to get 161 yards on 26 carries with Clyde Edwards-Helaire, you're going to have good possession the clock. And that just shows how garbage this Bills defense is. I thought this Bills defense was nice. Listen, RD, what happened to y'all Bills defense? What happened to this Bills defense? Because last year, all I was hearing was, this is a top five defense. Oh, look at all these studs. Look at all these athletic players. Trey White, Tremaine Edmonds, Jerry Hughes, Micah Hyde, Jordan Pryor. Where are y'all at? Where y'all at? Where y'all at? For the past 2 weeks, y'all have been a no-show. The Titans ran down y'all throat. Ryan Tannehill got busy throwing to AJ Brown and whoever. And now, I mean, you guys got dominated by the Chiefs. And a lot of it wasn't even in the air. Like, Tyreek Hill only had 3 catches for 20 yards. Travis Kelce only had 5 catches for 65 yards. And he had 2 touchdowns, but still. A lot of it was in the running game. So, at the end of the day, I mean, I like what I saw from the Bills, but I never bought in the Bills as a true Super Bowl contender. I still think the Patriots are the best team in that division. As bad as the Patriots and Cam Newton look right now, as long as Bill Belichick goes out and get a receiver, I think the Patriots still win that division. So that's why I take away from that game. The other games that I didn't touch in separate vids, Bears. Listen, I really can't hate on the Bears anymore. I mean, the Bears, as we all listen, in the back of my mind, we all know the Bears are fugazi. We know this offense is pathetic. We all know Matt Nagy is terrible in clutch situations. I mean, Matt Nagy does not how to control the clock in tight situations. See, he doesn't. Matt Nagy might have the worst clock management in all of sports. I mean, he really might. But at the end of the day, they still find the ways to win games, y'all. The Bears, they're 5-1. I mean, you can't hate on it. You can't hate on it. I mean, they lead the NFC North because the Packers lost to the Buccaneers and the Bears escaped with robbery in the week before. So the Bears, they're on top of their division. So, I mean, like, listen, right now it seems like I'm wrong on the Bears, but not really. I mean, at the end of the day, I told y'all this offense was some shit. I mean, am I lying? Is this offense lighting it up? I mean, it's it's like the Bears are always escaping with wins. But it's like at the end of the day, I can't hate on it. Because this defense, they're playing lights out. Khalil Mack, Akeem Hicks, the whole entire crew, Roquan Smith, Kyle Fuller. I mean, they're all playing really well. they're all playing really well. So at the end of the day, I can hear the defense has been playing lights out. So I mean, if you got a great defense with Nick Foles making clutch plays on third down, maybe that's a recipe to winning. But I just think come big time when you're facing the road teams, come playoff time, when you're facing my Seahawks, the Buccaneers again, Packers, Saints, when you're facing all these true contenders, it's like it's hard to believe in a team that really doesn't have a true offense. Like, they don't. Like, their only weapon is Allen Robinson. Please don't get it twisted. David Montgomery hasn't done anything. They don't have a number two receiver. Don't give me Jimmy Graham. This offense ain't it, but they still winning games, so it's hard to hate on them. Bengals and Colts, I mean, shout out to the Colts for making a 21-0 comeback, I guess. I mean, y'all play the Bengals. I mean, it's only so much I can congratulate Phillip Rivers. I mean, like, Phillip Rivers, in my opinion, he still looks like he's over the hill. I'm sorry, Phillip Rivers is still over the hill. But I mean, if some of these weapons can ball out, if you can actually get Jonathan Taylor to ball out, because Jonathan Taylor, truth be told, Jonathan Taylor sucked this year. It's funny that Seahawks fans are talking about drafting Jonathan Taylor in the first round, not only because we had Chris Carson and Carlos Hyde and Rashad Penny, but they thought Jonathan Taylor can be an upgrade. Whatever. I mean, this guy Jonathan Taylor hasn't really done anything. As far as Burrow's looked alright. He's looked alright. I mean, you gotta win some of these games, though. Like, I'm sorry, you gotta win some of these games. Like, it looks like him and T. Higgins has good chemistry. T. Higgins had 6 catches for over 125 yards. So, you know, overall, it looks like they got some chemistry. But then they are. Can y'all free AJ Green? AJ Green has shown that he doesn't want to be in Cincinnati anymore. He's shown perfectly that he doesn't want to be in Cincinnati. So at the end of the day, go and move him. Send AJ Green to Foxborough. Cam needs AJ Green because N'Keal Harry can't separate and save his life. So, you know, overall, send AJ Green to Foxborough. Ravens and Eagles. The Ravens are fugazi. I hope y'all realize that the Ravens almost blew a 20 point lead in the fourth quarter, y'all. Please don't get it twisted. The Eagles should have came back this game. If Carson Wentz has any type of weapons, if Carson Wentz number one receiver wasn't some random named Travis Fulgham, Carson Wentz and the Eagles win that game. Because this guy Lamar Jackson, dog. I told y'all, man, he's not that great of a quarterback, y'all. Is he a fun athlete to watch? Is he fun for the highlight tape? Does he make the splashy plays and the ooh-wees and this and the third? Of course he does. But at the end of the day, when it's time to make plays in that pocket, he just doesn't do it. He just doesn't do it. You can't put Lamar Jackson in the same category as a great one in Russell Wilson. You can't put him in the same category as number 15 in Kansas City. You can't put him in the same category as number 12 in Lambeau Field. You just can't. Because he's not that skilled in the pocket as a passer. I'm sorry. And by the way, one thing that could help Lamar Jackson also is giving him some goddamn weapons, because Marquise Brown, I'm sorry, Hollywood Brown is not a number one receiver. He's just not. He's not a number one receiver. Willie Snead, fuck out of here. I mean, they're lacking weapons. I mean, I don't believe in the Ravens as contenders. I'm sorry. We saw the Ravens get their brains obliterated come playoff time the past 2 years, because at the end of the day, when they get behind in games, they can't come back because Lamar Jackson is not a good enough passer to make these weapons look better than what they are. So at the end of the day, if you John Harbaugh, you need to swallow your pride and you need to get on the phone with Antonio Brown. You need to get on the phone with AJ Green. There's so many receivers on the open market. Hell, the Falcons just put Julio on the open market, y'all. The Falcons are talking about tanking. If I'm John Harbaugh, if I'm who's the GM there? It's not Ozzie Newham anymore. It's who gives a fuck? But whoever's running shit with the Ravens, I'm calling up Julio. I'm calling up AJ Green. I'm chatting up with AB. I'm doing something because ain't no way y'all can compete with the Steelers, a healthy Patriots team, or the Chiefs with these type of work. Oh hell, the Titans. Look how Ryan Tannehill is playing. Right now, Ryan Tannehill is a better quarterback than Lamar Jackson. So at the end of the day, the Ravens don't impress me. And overall, for the other games, like I said, nobody gives a fuck about Washington versus the Giants. Nobody gives a fuck about the Lions versus the Jaguars. Or just super vids on the Patriots and Broncos. I mean, that's all I really got to say. Oh, yeah, before I go, I need to speak about the Titans game. Titans and Texans. Listen, Derrick Henry's the best running back in the NFL, y'all. He is. There's no other way to really slice it. He's the best running back in the NFL, y'all. This guy right here, Derrick Henry, King Henry himself, he's an animal. He is a full-on animal, and we knew this, but my goodness, y'all. Nobody that big should be running that fast, y'all. Nobody that big should be running that fast. This guy, what? Derrick Henry is 6'3", 250 pounds, running full speed. Like, this guy, Derrick Henry, when he's in the open space, there is no catching him. Watch him run that 95-yard run was just, it's insane, y'all. This guy's 250 getting past linebackers and corners. Like, what the fuck? This shit, that's not supposed to happen. And then listen, this Titans offense, Ryan Tannehill looks exceptional. He does. He looks great in that play action offense. AJ Brown's a monster. Overall, this Titans team, they legit. I was wrong in this Titans team. I wasn't as optimistic as some people on the Titans just because I didn't believe in Ryan Tannehill. But at the end of the day, y'all, Ryan Tannehill is proving the entire world wrong. And guess what? Maybe Ryan Tannehill was this good all along. Maybe it was because he was getting shadowed by some piece of shit named Adam Gase. Maybe somebody didn't use Ryan Tannehill as high as potential. Now he got a great coach in Mike Vrabel and a good system. Now Ryan Tannehill is shining. Yeah, just another reason why Adam Gase is the worst coach I've ever seen. Anyway, that's all I really got to say, man. That's the Week 7 recap, y'all. We're going to keep a Week 6 recap. That's a Week 7 this entire time. Anyway, that's the Week 6 recap, y'all. Heading into Week 7. It's lit, y'all. It really is. But that's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm Lift from 91. And I'm out. Deuces.
To have bad luck, now you might see me in the Jag truck, masked up, even with a dime or a bad